One of the things I like about being in a learning environment is that it challenges you to learn about things that you might not otherwise learn or even think to find interesting. When I first decided on the AAA as a project, I had the thought to check on the history of the AAA, and holy cow, did it get interesting. I hope you find the AAA and its history as interesting as I have. The AAA, or abdominal aortic aneurysm, was known as far back as ancient Egypt and is mentioned among the oldest known medical documents, the Ebers Papyrus, dating back as far as 3400 BC. The treatment called for was to, quote, treat it with a knife and burn it with fire so that it bleeds not too much, end quote. The first documented physician to attempt surgery on the AAA was the 2nd century Greek physician Antyllus, where he described a process of ligating above and below the aneurysm and then draining the aneurysmal portion. This method is widely known as the Antyllus method and was the standard until the 19th century, a span of nearly 1700 years. Other notable advancements in the knowledge and/or techniques came in 400 AD, 1500 AD, and in 1923, when the first successful documented aneurysm repair using a modified approach to the ancient Antyllus method was used. Around this time, significant advancements began to emerge, and novel techniques for AAA repair included arterial walls that were scarified with talc wrapped in polyethylene or cellophane, or filled with meters of wire to which a galvanic current could be applied. Notably, Albert Einstein was operated on by Rudolf Nissen in 1949 using the polyethylene cellophane technique and survived another 6 years after the operation before the aneurysm ruptured. A patient was admitted to the hospital in 2013 for abdominal pain and was given a series of exams including abdominal and pelvic CT angiography with contrast. An abdominal aortic aneurysm measuring 73 millimeters by 82 millimeters was seen. According to the radiologist's report, the images were taken from above the celiac axis down through the groin after the administered contrast bolus. 80 milliliters of ISOVU 370 were administered intravenously without a reported adverse reaction. Three-dimensional, volume-rendered, MIP, shaded surface rendering reconstructions were post-processed and evaluated in multiple projections on a separate workstation. The normal abdominal aorta measures approximately 20 millimeters. An aneurysm is diagnosed at 30 millimeters, and surgery is indicated after 55 to 60 millimeters. With the patient's abdominal aorta measuring 73 millimeters wide, roughly 2.8 inches, it is 3.5 times the normal size. A AAA repair consists of two primary methods. From the time of Rudolf Nissen until recently, the primary technique for aortic repair has been an open surgery method to resect the aneurysmal area with a graft made of Dacron cloth. This method has given way more recently to a minimally invasive approach called endovascular aneurysm repair, or EVAR, where an expandable wire cage is inserted primarily through the femoral artery and advanced under imaging guidance to the aneurysmal area. When the cage is released, it self-expands and provides support to the area. The patient I met received the minimally invasive EVAR method. When I met the patient, it was for 1 year post-op follow-up images and appeared to be doing well. These follow-ups will continue throughout their life to monitor the area. This type of follow-up not only tracks the patient's progress, but also provides valuable long-term feedback on the procedure itself. The patient has been given the chance to enjoy a life that would have ostensibly been cut short without it, and the new EVAR method has significantly reduced the negative aspects of the older open surgery method for millions of people. While this method still seems like a high-tech version of the medieval chicken wire approach, we can expect the future to bring many more advances.